Over the next few minutes, I'm going to be telling you the best way to run your Facebook ads so that you could see the most conversions and the best fan development in your Spotify marketing campaigns. With that, my name is Mike Durante, and I'm the owner of a music marketing agency where we help artists generate genuine fans on Spotify and grow with consistency and predictability. If this is your first time stopping by the channel, I strongly consider subscribing, as this is the first of many videos in the music marketing space, as it's our goal to bring the skills and tactics that we're doing to help a plethora of artists behind the scenes to the front page so that we can help you grow and start to reach the goals that you've always dreamed of accomplishing. With that being said, this is going to be a more informational video, and I'm not going to be doing much on the computer. So if you do find this information helpful and want to know how you can apply it to your advertising campaigns, let me know in the comments, and I'll be sure to go into full detail on exactly how we are setting up these campaigns and seeing tremendous results with them. So let's dive into the best way to run your Facebook and Instagram ads for your music. So the first point that I need to get out of the way is that if you are boosting your posts on Instagram or clicking the promote button, you are doing it wrong. There's truly no other way to put it. You're basically just lighting your money on fire at that point. So if you are just boosting your posts on Facebook and Instagram, don't get down on yourself, but understand that it is such better methods out there to be pushing your content efficiently and effectively. This video is more meant for the people who do understand the power of Business Manager and are using it for their Facebook and Instagram advertising campaigns. So if you do want to understand why you shouldn't be boosting your posts, let me know in the comments below. I'll be sure to make a video explaining it in full detail. So, to explain the best way to utilize Facebook and Instagram to market your music, you need to first understand how Facebook's ad platform works. So simply put, Facebook wants you to spend more money. And how do they accomplish that? They accomplish it by getting more of what you're looking for at the cheapest cost possible. So let's just say you run a product store and you're looking to sell your shirts. If you run Facebook ads, Facebook is going to try its absolute hardest to get you as many purchases as possible so that you see it as a feasible marketing method and end up spending more money into the platform. If you spend $300 and you don't get a single purchase, you're not going to spend any more money. Whereas if you spend $300 and you get 30 purchases and it's profitable for you, you're going to end up putting $300 more, $600, $1,000 into ads because you see it as a good way to be spending your money. So all of Facebook's AI inside the ad platform is based around trying to get you more of your objective. This is super important to understand because it exposes the downfall of the conventional method of running Facebook ads for your music that most artists do. So now let me explain to you the conventional way that artists are running their campaigns and why it isn't the best way to be running your Facebook ads for your music. Most artists, when they go to run their campaigns, will run it with the objective of link clicks. This is where the start to finish process goes from the ad to the actual platform with no middle step in between. And the objective that we're optimizing towards is to get people to click on the link on the ad or swipe up on the story and get taken to the next location, which would be your Spotify page, your Apple Music page, the YouTube music video, or wherever you're hosting the actual song. Most people think that this is a really good way to be running your ads because they see cheap results, they see consistent conversions, but there really is a lot of issues at hand. So the biggest issue with link click campaigns is what is going on inside the optimization and what Facebook is doing completely on its own. And this isn't a downfall of Facebook, but it's just simply because of Facebook's ad platform's goal to get you more of the results you want at a cheaper rate. So this main issue revolves around bots. Any advertising platform, heck, even any social media platform, has a market for bots. There are so many bots out there, and as you are spending money into your marketing efforts, you need to make sure you have a plan in place or system set up that cuts out the bots and doesn't let them get through to your final product. So when you run link click campaigns on Facebook and Instagram, you are in direct territory to be botted. Regardless of where you show the content, even if you're showing it in just the US or just your local town, there is potential that bots will see the ad and they will interact with it. The thing with bots is that they take one impression to get one conversion. So it literally costs barely even a cent for you to get a conversion. And in Facebook's eyes, since your goal is just a link click, Facebook sees that as the best conversion to get you. And like I previously stated, since Facebook wants to get you the cheapest and most conversions possible so that you spend more money, you actually begin to optimize towards showing your ads to bots. And what this leads to is no conversions on the actual platform, no conversions on your actual song, no fans developed, and no growth to your career. With a link click campaign as well, the only objective is to click a link. So even if you happen to not be showing it to bots, the Facebook is optimizing around people who will only click the link, not people who will click the link, go to the next page, go to your Spotify page, and then take an action inside of Spotify. There are so many other reasons why link click campaigns are not the best way to be doing your music marketing, but this is the most important reason. And for sake of your time and the video, I don't need to really go into full much more detail and explain more reasons of why link clicks aren't a good campaign. When you see it right here, you're showing your content to bots and you're not sending the traffic that is most likely to actually convert into a fan to your music. And at the end of the day, cheap clicks are great, but we're not in this for cheap clicks and cheap numbers and quantity of numbers. We are in this for building quality fans. So this leads me to bring up the best way to run your Facebook and Instagram ads for your music. This is through leveraging a conversion campaign. So the difference between a link click campaign and a conversion campaign is a conversion campaign is not just clicking the link and going to a different page outside of the Facebook app. It is clicking a link, going to a page, and then taking an action on that page. That is the conversion, and that is what Facebook will optimize for. So the first main reason why conversion campaigns work so much better than any other form of Facebook ads for your music is because you are putting yourself in the best position to get rid of any bot traffic. Most bots don't have the ability to take more than one action. It's really not affordable for bot farms to do, and it takes a tremendous amount of coding to create it. So with that being said, just by running conversion campaigns, Facebook isn't going to optimize towards any bots that will potentially click your link and instead optimize towards the real people who are actually converting on your music. The other main benefit around conversion campaigns is that you get to utilize the Facebook pixel. The Facebook pixel is your best friend when it comes to running ads. It is the most important tool in our arsenal. And if you don't know what it is, it's essentially it's a piece of code that allows us to track the people who are converting on our campaigns to create lookalike audiences, retargeting campaigns, and overall have so much more power in the optimization process. So the best way to run campaigns for your music is to not only just run a conversion campaign, but to also run a conversion campaign that leverages the power of the Facebook pixel. So how do we do that, you may ask? Well, you can't actually embed your pixel into Spotify or into Apple Music. So you have to use different landing pages and different hyperlink resources to accomplish this. Two of them that I personally use are ToneDin.io and Hypedit. These aren't too expensive and they give you the power to use the Facebook pixel, which at the end of the day is the most important thing and the biggest game changer in your music marketing campaigns. So in comparison to link click campaigns, conversion campaigns are actually optimizing to show the ads to the people who are going to convert into real fans. Since when you run a conversion campaign, you're telling Facebook that you don't care about the link clicks, you care about the conversions, which is sending people to your music platform. So when Facebook sees a link click that doesn't actually convert, they don't value that and they don't optimize towards that. Where when it sees the real people who see your ad, click the link, go to the landing page, then click the listen on Spotify button, those are the people who they want to show the ad to. So instead of showing it to more bots, you actually start to show it to more people at a cheaper rate without having to do any manual optimization. And as I briefly stated before, conversion campaigns give you the ability to create custom audiences that are extremely high converting. You can 100% make custom audiences with your link click campaigns, but the serious issue with that is that you do not have quality information. There's an extremely high potential that low quality traffic is clicking your links. So at the end of the day, a lookalike audience or a retargeting audience based around those crappy link clicks are not going to get you any more quality listeners or quality fans. One of the lesser data-driven benefits to running conversion campaigns that is more on the psychological side is the amount of intent that a conversion campaign develops. So where we have seen the best results in terms of fan development is when we run these conversion campaigns and make the people who are converting on the ads take multiple steps so that they have an extremely high intent to listen to your music. We make them do micro commitments, which is such an important part in the sales funnel inside of a product business. So in this case, inside of the fan building funnel that we are trying to create with our advertisements. So you may think that quickest is the best, but in certain cases, you actually want people to take more steps. This is when quality is your goal and not quantity. And I just have to say, if you're in this for the numbers and just trying to get a big amount of streams, you are building a very weak foundation, one that will not be able to support the weight of a big career. Your goal should be to build real, genuine fans that support you and will stay with you for the longevity of your career. So with link click campaigns, there's really only one action that the potential fan needs to take to go from start to finish in your process. And that's just simply interacting with the ad. You can make the argument that they also have to click play on your song once they get to Spotify. So for sake of that, we'll say that there's two steps in the link click process. With the conversion process, there's three steps that the potential listener needs to take. Clicking on the ad, going to the landing page, and then clicking to go to Spotify. So they've already made more investments and more micro commitments to listening to your song. This leads them to have such a higher intent to not only listen to one song, but listen to multiple songs and overall convert into a long-term fan. So this is nearly scratching the surface on why conversion campaigns are so much more powerful than any other way of marketing your music through Facebook ads. And I know that I didn't go into too much detail on how to actually do it inside of Business Manager. So if you do want to learn exactly how me and my agency are running our music marketing conversion campaigns, let me know in the comments below. I would love to go into full detail on exactly how we do it and give you all the tips and tricks so that you could start building the fan base you've always dreamed of. As well, if there were any specific points throughout this video that I made that you want to hear me expand on further, also let me know about that. I'm here to help you guys, and I want to see you create the career that you've always dreamed of having. So anywhere that I can help, I am absolutely willing and happy to do it. Also, if you do want to learn more about the team here at Advanced Media and what we do and how we are helping artists build true fan bases, click the first link down below as it will take you directly to the music section of our website. And one last request that I do have, as you see, this is the first music marketing based video that I put out on my channel. So if you guys have any topics in terms of music marketing that you would love to see videos on, please let me know down below, as I would absolutely love to take inspiration from what you guys want to learn and give you the info and value that you're looking to hear. So with that being said, please make sure to like and comment on this video. Show some feedback and support, as I greatly, greatly appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. And as always, chase your dreams and don't wait till tomorrow to start. Start right now. This is Mike Durante signing off, and I will see you in the next video.